thanks for watching my video today. I want to talk about trailer safety and specifically changing a tire on the side of the road. I've had to do this two or three times over the last year, and mainly that's my fault. One of the things I found out was I had my tires on my trailer inflated way too much. The pressure was just too high and it was causing me to have blowouts, and I've since fixed that. But through that experience, I've learned what to carry with me to make the process of changing a tire on the side of the road safer and faster. First of all, you need to have a really good spare tire. So you'll see in front of me, I've got a nice Carlisle steel belted radial. It's a load E rating that I picked up from Walmart. You can get this tire and the wheel for probably about 70, 75 bucks. Don't quote me on that, but check it out for yourself. I think that's in the ballpark. But always have a really good tire with you in the bed of your truck or whatever you're driving so that you can make that switch and have a good, reliable tire to get you the rest of the way home. A couple of other things that I carry. I actually carry this bag, and in this bag, I carry a tire tool. So this is one of those that has the swivel head on it. It makes it really easy to take those nuts on and off. Just a very simple tool I got from Harbor Freight, not much money at all. What, I might have paid 10 bucks for that, something like that. And then also I've got the piece here on the end. It's a Pittsburgh brand that I got also at Harbor Freight as well to get those lug nuts on and off. The other thing I carry in this bag is, and I know some of you will probably laugh at me, but it's an impact wrench, and it's an electric one. And the reason why it's electric is one, it's cheaper. And two, I have an electrical outlet in the bed of my truck. Now, this thing's not very powerful, but what it does is it speeds up the process of changing the tire. So what I'll do is just very quickly plug this in, pull it back to the tire that needs to be changed. I might loosen it with this, but then I've got the piece on the end there to take it off really quickly. So it just speeds up the process a little bit. So again, having the right sockets, having the tire tool, and then, this is completely optional. Probably a lot of guys would be like, man, that's stupid that you're doing that. But I really like having that. I feel like it speeds it up a lot, so I'm not standing over there doing this on every one of the lug nuts. Other thing I carry, of course, is a light. You want to have something to illuminate the area that you're working in. And also, I really like these because they have the hook on them, so you can hook it to the trailer or just where it's convenient so that you're not having to hold it, and then you can, hang it from something, illuminate the area that you're working on. Now, this is really what I wanted to talk about right here, because I think these couple of items that I'm going to talk about are things that we often skip out on, and I know I did for the longest time. First of all, having a reflective vest. So this is an orange, very reflective vest. You can see the silver reflective material here. You're going to put this on, and as soon as you get out of the truck, start working, you need to have this with your changing kit, and put this on, because honestly, whether it's during the daytime or the nighttime, you need to do everything you can to make yourself visible to other drivers. I don't think it's any secret that people are not driving very well these days because they're very distracted. They're on the phone, they're texting, or they're doing whatever they're doing in the car. They're talking to their kids, those sorts of things. And I mean, we've seen so many people that have been on the side of the road, state troopers, incident management and assistance patrol workers, people that are on the side of the road either writing tickets or helping drivers who need assistance, and they're getting hit and they're getting injured and they're getting killed because people can't see them, or more likely people just aren't paying attention. So everything that we can do to make ourselves more visible to the drivers that are passing by, we need to do that. So this, again, it's a vest. I got it on Amazon. I think I paid $3 for it. I'll put the links to some of these things in the video, so if you want to check it out, you can. But again, $3 to save your life, I think it's worth it. Last thing I'll talk about are triangles. So I have this kit of three triangles here, and these are neat because they fold up. I'm gonna pull these apart. see if I can do it here without breaking it. There we go. Got that on the other side. So these fold like this, and they go into this little box that I keep in the bed of my truck. And you know, you just pull them out. You got three of them. Pop them up like that. Yep. And they'll click at the top. And so it's super easy to use. And then you just turn it. This black part here, I guess kind of the base, I think it has sand in it. Yeah, I think that's sand. And so it's real sturdy, it's real heavy. But what you want to do is put three of these out. Now, some folks will, 10, 20 feet apart, put three of them just straight in a line. So, you know, behind your trailer, three of them straight in a line. Some people like to start one over here, one here, and one here, so that when drivers are coming towards you, the reflections give the illusion of telling people to move that way or to move, you know, away from the shoulder of the road. So something to think about. I believe I might have paid $15 or $20 for this little set of reflective triangles. Again, I think that's pretty cheap for such a necessary safety item that really could save your life. Folds up really easily. Again, goes into this little box, closes, and you just throw it in the bed of your truck, and that way they're not sliding around all over everywhere. So, again, triangles, vest, most importantly, the tire tool, Harbor Freight, socket, Harbor Freight, and a light. So, just wanted to talk about that today, guys. Not an ATV or a side-by-side specific thing, but surely if you're pulling one of those items, you're pulling a trailer as well. And hopefully you haven't had any blowouts yet, but you really do need to be prepared for one. Okay, thanks for tuning in, and please click the subscribe button on my YouTube channel, please, if you don't mind. I'd love to have you follow me. And also on Facebook as well. I really love interacting with all of you. I learn just as much from you as you do from me. And if you have any suggestions about other things to carry or other ways to do this, put that down in the comments below, and let's help each other out. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.
Make up your mind. Decide to walk with me around the lake tonight.